the Republicans have taken a huge hit, be it temporary or longer. But nobody's scot-free here. My question to you about the president, whose popularity has also dropped, is, do you think that as a part of his legacy, he wants to be the first president to preside over a default? Is that enough to bring him to the table?
No, it's not. And I don't think he's going to come to the table. Look, we've asked about Ted Cruz and where he's taken the party. Look, if you throw a skunk in the chicken coop, everybody knows you got to get the skunk out before he kills the chickens and eats the eggs. But everybody's going to get smell on him. And that's what's happened here. We've got smell on the Republican Party. It's spilling over to the president and to the Democrats. And what the rest of the country is seeing is dysfunction. And look, there's going to have to be some people rise above. There's going to be people in the middle on the Democratic side and the Republican side that breaks this loose and brokers it. Look, we have got to have the Speaker of the House speak to the majority of the Senate. This is the legislative body. They ought to be working this thing out, not rushing over to the president and say, solve our problem. He's there with the pen at the end, but the legislative branch has got to solve this.
Really? I mean, you don't think that that's something the president would like to avoid? I mean, the president isn't fact in charge.
Well, Candy, the president is in charge of the executive branch of the government. I think the Constitution's been pretty clear who has the spending power here. And let me just, you promised me a chance to say something about Ted Cruz, and so I want to say that, which is he's an extraordinarily smart person who should not be underestimated. And to the extent he is the face of the Republican Party going into 2014, he will excite an important part of their base. And he will excite an important part of the Democratic base. So I think he's a critical political figure moving forward. So, you know, we'll all keep
an eye.
Don't underestimate him. Let me just mention something about the president, though, which is his basic position is he is happy to talk, and he is talking, and he is talking and talking, but he's not going to negotiate in order to get Congress to do its job, which is to behave as responsible legislators and keep this country from going into a default.
But as we all know, there have been negotiations before about these very same issues.
Well, I would say that, but I don't think that anybody before was ever really willing to put this country into default. And the absence of leadership that Governor Schweitzer talked about is really the danger here. And it's not on the part of the White House. It is on the part of Congress.
The president, legacy?
You just heard the party line outlined eloquently. I think this president is engaged in another audacious strategy, just as Obamacare was audacious, just as running for president was audacious, just as the way in which they did the stimulus was audacious. And his strategy is to strip the House Republicans of the ability to force him to negotiate. I think it's a deliberate strategy. I think he is executing it very willfully. I think he has in Harry Reid somebody who is even more aggressive than he is. And the test of the next week is going to be simple. Do the House Republicans stand firm and say, you have to negotiate, as, by the way, on the debt ceiling we have for 60 years since Eisenhower, and we've had 18 shutdowns since 1976, so none of this is new. But this president has decided that he wants to be legislator-in-chief, not just commander-in-chief, and this is a big deal historically.
I want to put a quick poll up there. It's the right direction, wrong direction poll, which so many politicians look at going into an election. Asked whether the country's going in the right direction, wrong direction, 14% of Americans said it's going in the right direction. 78% said it's going, it's on the wrong track.
You want to meet those 14%?
Yes, you do, because I think this speaks to a mistrust of the federal government. And while I understand that Republicans, you know, think that's healthy, you have to somehow believe in your government. Isn't that also one of the byproducts of this mess?
No, we distrust the federal government, and we ought to.
Right.
Look, we now have a government shutdown, but we're still paying the people. That's the cost of running government. And secondly, if you really want to cut the cost of government, there's four places you get it. You got to get it from Social Security, you got to get it from health care, Medicare, and Medicaid, and you got to get it from defense. When people talk about, oh, I'm going to shut this down or close this down or the parks this, those are rounding errors. If you want to talk about the cost of running government, talk about the real things.